Welcome to the Penrith Solar Centre Solar Academy. Today, we are going to be diving into the return on investment, or commonly known as ROI, of solar and battery systems. In this video, we're going to cover the factors influencing the cost and design of your solar and battery system, calculating the ROI for solar panels, and the additional factors that go into maximizing the return on investment when you buy solar and battery storage. So let's get started. First and foremost, what exactly is ROI, or return on investment? Well, in the solar industry, it's seen to be the amount of money that you spend on a solar system and how long it takes you to recuperate that cash in years measured on energy bill savings. So for example, if you spend $10,000 on a solar system and you save $2,500 per year on electricity, your return on investment, or ROI, would be 4 years, which would be a fantastic result. So when calculating the ROI of your solar system, there are a few key things that influence this and some key points you'll need to know. The first thing to think about is, what size solar system are you actually going to buy? And to work this out, it's very important that you understand the energy demands of your household. Next up is the equipment and the installation cost breakdown. Are you planning on using a microinverter for your installation? Or are you going to go the more budget option and install a string inverter? One will cost more, the other will be slightly cheaper. And another thing that's important is, you've got to focus on the size or the system output for your money. So that's your value for money, ignoring quality, of course, thinking about, what is the dollar per watt that I'm about to spend on my solar system? That is a very good way to actually compare apples with apples when comparing company A with company B. Working out the dollar per watt is simply taking the total system expense, that could be $10,000, and dividing it by the system size. So if you have a 10 kilowatt system for 10 grand, looks like you're about $1,000 per kilowatt, or $1 per watt. Number two, calculating the return on investment for your solar panels and your battery storage. ROI, based on the initial investment and yearly savings, given with the example that I gave just a moment earlier, you'll need to work out the self-consumption and the feed-in tariffs that may be available for any excess energy you're going to sell to the grid. You'll also want to work out whether you're planning on putting your system into a VPP program, which is a virtual power plant. So once you've worked out the rates that are available to you, and if you're going to put your solar system on a virtual power plant, one of the next things you want to work out is how long you were going to live in this home for, and is it important to you that your system A, pays itself off really fast, or B, lasts a really long time? You see, a string inverter system will typically pay itself off a little bit quicker than a microinverter system. The simple fact is that they cost less than a microinverter system does in terms of upfront costs. However, a microinverter system coupled with some great panels and a high quality install is more than capable of lasting 25 to 30 years. The same cannot be said for a string inverter system. In fact, I've never seen a string inverter last more than 15 years. It's all well and good to have a solar system that pays itself off a year quicker, and it might bring your money back 4 times over 15 years, which sounds like an incredible deal. And to be fair, it is a great deal. But there might be something better on the market. What if you had a system that bought your money back 7 times over 25 years? Although it took 1 year longer to pay itself back, in the future years to come, it's going to work harder for you. And importantly, it is actually going to work for you. It's not going to be a system that's going to find itself into landfill. So when calculating your ROI, you would want to start thinking about, am I actually going to have to put another solar system on this house in the future? Number three, what enhancements and considerations can I look into for a better ROI on my solar system? Well, first and foremost is the roof space and the panel placement that you're going to put on your home. The quality of installation and less downtime means obviously more energy over the life of the system, which will certainly give you a better return on investment. The impact of your energy needs is dramatically going to change the return on investment as well. If your system that you install is too big, what you'll find is your bills will be very impressive, but your return on investment may take a little bit longer. The opposite is true if the system you install is a little bit too small. If the system's too small, the payback period will be really, really fast, but the net result on your bills might not quite be as impressive as what you thought they were going to be. Other enhancements are, of course, battery storage. Are you going to add a battery on to self-consume every little bit of energy that you possibly can, or are you going solar only for now? And are you going to be happy with a reduced feed-in tariff compared to what it has been historically? The next question is are you going to go the microinverter system or the string system? All these facts will dramatically change your return on investment. However, nothing could quite change your return on investment like having a solar system on your roof that doesn't work. So it's really, really important to have a solar system that's going to stand up to the test of time. A cheap system with a fast payback period might seem like a good idea at the time, but I promise you, at year five, it's going to be one of the biggest regrets and one of the poorest decisions that you may have actually made. Point number four, additional factors to maximize your return on investment. What exactly is the role of battery storage in self-consumption? Are you actually on the right energy plan? And did you end up signing up to that virtual power plant? Having the right energy plan and bolting on a battery and bolting on a virtual power plant program to your solar and battery system are all items or things that will supercharge your return on investment. You see, putting solar and batteries on your home is only half the job. If you have it connected to an energy plan that's not really working for you, or the rates are still really expensive, you're still going to have a fair bit of a bill. And that, of course, affects your return on investment. So long after the install's done, it's important that every year you stay up to date with the best plans and offerings on the market. This will help supercharge your return on investment. So to answer the ever complex question of predicting your solar return on investment, it can be as soon as around 4 years, and you bolt on battery storage, it can actually be as long as 8 to 9 years. Typically with Penrith Solar Center using N-phase microinverters, N-phase batteries, or of course the Tesla Powerwall 2, we see our solar systems pay themselves off in between 4.5 to 5 years. If you bolt a battery on, we're seeing returns as quick as 7 years, all the way out to about 8.5 years. This, of course, depends on everything we just spoke about. I hope that this gives you great clarity when thinking about return on investment of your solar system. And I've got a bonus tip for you before I let you go. When calculating ROI and thinking about driving an electric vehicle in the future, it's important to take into consideration what the cost of petrol is or diesel at that point in time as well. For me, I have a very big solar system and battery storage, of course, on my home. I'm not yet on a virtual power plant, but the day will come very shortly where I do sign up to a virtual power plant. I think it will really supercharge the returns of my own solar system. But a big part that I take into consideration, which actually shaves about a year off my return on investment, is that I'm a family with 2 electric vehicles. We have not been to a service station in around 2 years, which is great for me. And the little bonus of not going to a service station is that I don't get conned in to buying the 2-for-1 Gatorades. All these things for me go into my return on investment, justify and make me satisfied with my decision to go solar and of course battery storage. If you want to learn a little more and you want to check out the rest of our videos, jump on our PSC Solar Academy, have a look at them, immerse yourself, make great decisions. Until the next one, I'm Jake from Penrith Solar. We'll see you there.